Hey everyone, welcome back to a new video. In this video, we are going to learn how to design a micropatch antenna using MATLAB. So without any further ado, let's get started. Let's start with the little basics of a micropatch antenna and the PCB which you should know before designing one. So, a micropatch antenna is basically made up of three layers. Number one layer is the ground layer itself, which is connected to the ground of the circuit, obviously. Second layer is the substrate, or you can call it a dielectric, which is generally Bakelite or FR4 epoxy glass, or you can use Artioduroid, it's up to you. And the third and the most important layer is the patch layer itself, or you can say antenna patch, which radiates. So these three layers combined form a micropatch antenna. Now we will be using a copper clad or a PCB while designing the antenna. So here I have one. Now this one in particular is a double-sided copper clad with a FR4 material in between as a substrate. Now while designing, I will be using the entire surface of the PCB as an antenna. So we should know the dimension of the PCB. Now in your case, it might be different. Since I am using the entire PCB as ground plane or the entire antenna, so the dimension of this PCB in particular is 6 inches in length, 4 inches in width, and a thickness of 1.6 millimeters. So that you should know. Now, once we know the dimension, we should also know the epsilon R value of the substrate. Now, I know this one has a FR4 material as the substrate. So if you Google around, you will find that FR4 material has a epsilon R value of 4.4. It's not really a big deal. You can just Google it. So that's all you need to know. Now let's jump into the MATLAB and see how to design a micropatch antenna. So let's jump into it. Okay, so we are in the MATLAB right now, and as you can see, I already have written two of this code. Now this one is an example code which we'll be going through in this video. And this one is the actual antenna which I designed quite a while back. And this one is slightly advanced than this example code, but it is really easy to understand once you understand this example code. So let's first go through with this. Okay, so in this example code, first of all, as you can see over here, I have written the size of the PCB. So as discussed earlier, PCB thickness is 1.6 millimeters, then PCB length, which is 6 inches, or if you convert it into millimeters, it will be 152.4 millimeters. Then PCB width, similarly 4 inches or 101.6 millimeters. So once we have this PCB size, then we will create the PCB material. Now, as I know, my PCB has FR4 material, so I have written it FR4 over here. Now you will see that it has MATLAB has highlighted this as slightly purplish, which means that MATLAB understand that we are using an FR4 material in this design. Now once we have written the FR4 material as PCB material, now we need to tell MATLAB that what is the epsilon R value of that FR4. So over here I have written the epsilon R value of the PCB, which is 4.4. So once we are done with that, now we will create a dielectric material over here. So as you can see, I have used this dielectric function, and inside that I have feed this FR4 value, which means we are creating a dielectric material of FR4. So once we have that, now we need to tell the MATLAB that epsilon R value of that dielectric is epsilon R, which means 4.4 over here. Now once we have done that, now we need to tell the MATLAB what is the thickness of that dielectric, which is PCB thickness, so 1.6 millimeter. As you can see, I have written that over here. Now over here, as you can see, I have designed this ground plane, and I have created a group, or you can say an object, whatever you want to call it. And inside that, I have created this rectangle of length, PCB length, which is 6 inches, then PCB width, as you can see over here, of 4 inches. So we are creating a ground plane inside this antenna of which has a shape of rectangle with length of PCB length, which is 6 inches, and width of PCB width, which is 4 inches. So we have created this ground plane of the antenna. Now similarly, we will create an antenna plane. So once again, inside this antenna group or object, I have created another rectangle of length 5 centimeter and width of 5 centimeter, which is centered at 0.0. So it is exactly in the center of the antenna. So I hope you understand this part as well. Now once we have done that, we will create a PCB stack. Now to create this PCB stack, we use this PCB stack. It is really simple. You just have to write P equals PCB stack. So inside that, now we will write the name of the type of feed we are using. So I am using this strip feed slot. Now you can use anything you want. You can just Google what are the different types of feed. Now for my purpose, I am using this one. Then we will tell the MATLAB what is the shape of the board. So as I told you earlier, I will be using the entire PCB. So entire PCB is the same as the PC ground plane. So I am using the board shape as the ground plane. Now thickness of this board, which is PCB thickness, so 1.6 millimeters of PCB thickness, which I have already declared over here. Now we will create the layers of this PCB. So first of all, the antenna plane, then we have this dielectric which we created over here. You can see D over here. Then we have the ground plane. So we created these three layers. Now we have done that. So next we will tell the MATLAB where is the feed location. So feed location is exactly at the center, 0, 0, which is x, y coordinate. And this feed starts from the first layer, which is our ground plane, till the third layer, which is our antenna patch. Now, once we have done that, once again, we have to tell MATLAB that our layers are antenna plane, dielectric, and the ground plane. So that's all you need to do for to create the antenna. Now we have created our antenna. We have made it into a PCB. And now we need to see our antenna. To now display our antenna or show our antenna, we can simply use this show P or show in brackets P, and it will show us our antenna. Now next we also need to understand our radiation pattern of the antenna. So as you can see, I have used this pattern function which displays the radiation pattern. Now I have written it 1.82 gigahertz over here. So this radiation pattern function will display the radiation pattern at 1.82 gigahertz. Now why I have written this? Once you go through the rest of the code, you will understand why I have chosen this 1.82, because I got the best S11 value or you can best gain of the antenna at this frequency. That's why I am displaying the pattern over here. Now once we have displayed our radiation pattern of the antenna, next really important parameter is the impedance of our antenna, which you should know while designing your antenna or when you are simulating or testing your antenna. So the impedance pattern we are showing for our antenna P, which we have designed over here, and we will start our impedance pattern from 1.6 gigahertz till 2.2 gigahertz in steps of 20 megahertz. So it will display the impedance graph from 1.6 gigahertz to 2.2 gigahertz. You can change this value according to your need. Now next, we are creating a vector using line space function, once again from 1.6 gigahertz to 2.2 gigahertz in steps of 50. Now why I have done this, you will understand over here, to calculate the S parameter or S11. Now I have used this S to store the value and then use this S parameter function to plot S11 for our antenna P for the frequency of this vectors in all 50. So once we have done that, we will simply use this RF plot function to plot the S11 graph. So once you have done all this, now if you run this code, you will see your antenna. So here is our antenna, here is our radiation pattern. Now it is calculating the impedance graph and now it is calculating the S11 plot. And as you can see, this antenna is not really good because we are only getting barely about how much? Minus 0.12 dB drop of S11 graph. Now this is not really ideal, but as you can see, we got all the parameter. Here is our antenna. I will rotate. This is our ground, entire ground plane, and this is our antenna patch. This is our impedance and this is our radiation pattern. So if I just change few values, you can see everything just changes. Now let's say I change my patch size to 5 cm by 1 cm. Let's change that and see what difference it makes. So as you can see, our antenna shape changed over here. Radiation pattern also changed and impedance is almost same, but you can see we got a slight change. Slight change in S11 plot, but still it's not really good. Okay, so now let me show you my antenna design, which I have done quite a while back. So here is my antenna which I have designed. As you can see, this part of the code is almost the same, just slight changes over here, and this part is also almost the same. And if you see, this is the extra part which I have added. Now what I have done, I have created some more shapes and at the end I have added all those shape to create an H kind of pattern. So it's kind of a H shape micro patch antenna, and in the end I have just displayed this using, once again, almost everything is same, just there's a different kind of shape to this antenna. So let me show you the design of the antenna. So as you can see, it's H kind of shape. Let everything load first. So here is our impedance pattern. As you can see, almost the 50 ohms impedance. As you can see over here, reactance and the impedance, and here is the S11 plot. Now this S11 plot is really good. You can see I have got S11 of minus 17, which is respectable, and then here is our impedance and the reactance, which is about 53. This is all ideal result, keep that in mind. And here is our radiation pattern, which is also really good. And here is the shape of the antenna, just in case if you are interested. You can see it's H kind of shape, slightly weird shape for H, but still it works. And there's our feed. You can see I have feed over here. And let me show you the ground plane. And this is the entire ground plane. So as you can see, you can just play around with this code and design your own antenna, and you can make your own antenna. Now this, my particular design is for 1.94 gigahertz, but when I did the actual testing on vector network analyzer, I got a different results. Let me show you. So here is the practical, which I connected my antenna to this VNA device, which is like a spectrum analyzer, or it basically scans the antenna and tells where is your antenna working for the best frequency. Now my antenna was working in this range, which is, as you can see over here, about 2.4 gigahertz. So my practical design was little bit off, but that is to be expected because I designed my antenna completely using this PCB clad. So you can say this is my antenna design. You can see there are some imperfection here, and then there was like a lot of solder over here, which should I should use a less solder over here. And you can see even the ground plane, it was slightly dirty. So all these things affect your antenna result, and this is the BNC jack which I used for my antenna. Alright, that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. So if you guys need any kind of material which might help you for designing your own antenna, I will link it down in the video description. You can check it out along with the code which I used in this video. So yeah, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button, share this video with your friends, and subscribe for more awesome content like this. And I will see you guys in the next one.